grew up with a mother that had a dance studio, and we were always dancing and doing acrobatics, but it was probably Olga Corbett that came by in 72, and then Kathy Rigby, and later in 76, it was Nadia Comaneci. So they were all inspirational to us. Every little girl wanted to be an Olympian.
She probably was a gymnast from childhood. It was just natural for her.
Donna was in high school, 72, 73, and 74, when Joe Holt, athletic director, and Harry Vandergrift, superintendent, wanted to have more activities for girls. They brought us some gymnastics equipment. And it was really primitive gymnastics equipment. And I really was hesitant to let them get any higher than I could reach or that someone could reach in spotting.
I really believe we were pioneers. We were pioneers and we had fun learning and we had fun growing in the sport. And it was just so much fun to compete and be part of a program that eventually became one of the best in the state.
We had girls who could do, somersaults and roundoffs and roundoff backhand springs. But Donna was the first one that could put the three together in a pass, the roundoff, backhand spring, back summer.
But Miss Bruner, I think she just put all the cheerleaders on the team because, you know, we didn't have a team. We had eight cheerleaders, and we all got to be really, really close. In our senior year, we went to Norman, Oklahoma for a cheerleading camp. And that was the first time Fayetteville High School had ever sent a group of cheerleaders out of state for a camp. And we came home with all kinds of awards. We won the Spirit Award at camp. We won the competition for the week. And of course, a lot of it had to do with Donna because back then, gymnastics wasn't a part of cheerleading. You know, cheerleading, we just led the cheers and got the crowd involved. But when Donna started, she introduced gymnastics into cheerleading.
So not only did we learn skills, but we had to work together and teach the skills to each other and spot. So I discovered that I loved spotting and coaching the other kids on the team. So by the time I graduated, I knew I wanted to pursue a career in gymnastics coaching.
She was one of the first two Fayetteville girls to get an athletic scholarship. And she was on one of the first gymnastics teams at the university.
She was a university cheerleader. And she ran her mom's gymnastics program at the gym. She created her own reputation just through hard work. Well, she retired from judging, but she was a highly sought after judge in the NCAA.
What I did at Fayetteville High School with the gymnastics, even though it was just 3 years, I think it changed the course of my life. You know, I was loved gymnastics. I loved the learning, I loved the spotting, and that's exactly what I do now.
At the Williams Center, there's no telling how many young people went through or have gone through over the years.
You know, I think she'd probably tell you, outside of her family, her biggest accomplishment is the number of lives that she has been able to touch through gymnastics.